Luxembourg's Fortuneau of Quake Den Haag. This is the occasion of the 21st Eurovision Song Contest, and this year there are more people watching and listening to it than any other year. It's estimated that around 600 million people in 40 countries will witness this annual musical jamboree, which will end in a few hours amid scenes of ecstasy for some and tears and bitter recriminations for others. 18 countries are taking part, and as well as the participating countries, the show will be seen in places like Hong Kong, the Soviet Union, Mexico, and the Fiji Islands. There are some changes in the lineup. Sweden, last year's host country, has decided to opt out, as have Malta and Turkey. The moment Turkey announced their withdrawal, however, the Greeks announced their intention to take part. The city of The Hague, the seat of government, the royal residence, is undoubtedly one of the most carefully planned cities in the world. In recent years, instead of demolishing old houses, rehabilitation was encouraged. The authorities have given a complete facelift to old houses. Windows enlarged, showers introduced, kitchens modernized, colors added. Where houses were past saving, they were demolished, and on their sites, instead of office blocks, cheerful medium-sized blocks of flats were erected by the government. They were erected for the fans of the old houses, most of whom are, of course, delighted to be able to remain in their own neighborhood. This week, the Israeli delegation, the Portuguese, and ourselves are locked away in splendid isolation at a seaside resort about 10 miles from the city. The hotel is surrounded by an estimated 200 security guards, many of whom are being led around by large, savage-looking dogs. The surrounding sand dunes are constantly patrolled by sinister-looking men in black leather coats and caps, carrying guns and telescopes. It would appear that the Irish song received more airplays on Dutch radio this week than any other Eurovision entry. While a certain amount of the credit must go to the very efficient Red Hurley publicity machine, the song is extremely popular, and the fact that it's one of only four ballads in the competition, the other 14 being of the bouncy, up-tempo variety, must surely aid its chances of success. Certainly there's no lack of support for Red and Brendan Graham, the composer who brought his wife, mother, father and brother along for moral support. There is some justification for the argument that the Eurovision is not a song contest as such, that it's a singer's contest. The limelight throughout the week undoubtedly belongs to the singers, and the ultimate success, while guaranteeing international stardom for the winning performer, is very often just a fleeting moment in the spotlight for the composer. The official book for the contest is quite interesting. The betting list, compiled by William Hill of London. Britain 3-1 favourites, followed by Italy and Norway at 6-1. Then come Germany, France, Israel and so on, down to Ireland at 25-1. Of course, William Hill may be just a little partisan in this instance, because while the British entry is expected to finish in the top five, the word of mouth favours present is Monaco, which is only slightly above Ireland in the betting at 20-1. The Congress Centre, which is the venue for the show, is a complex of which the people of The Hague are rightly proud. It includes an exhibition hall, a couple of restaurants, an art gallery, and the 2,000-seat theatre from which the show comes tonight. Must be one of the best equipped and most luxurious in the world. Before tonight's show is fascinating. Geometric shapes suspended from above the stage, which change pattern and color, complement the singer's costumes and the mood of the song. The commentary for the evening, Corrie Brooke.
Vanuit Den Haag in Nederland verwelkom ik 450 miljoen televisiekijkers, verdeeld over 33 landen, en 80 miljoen radioluisteraars, verdeeld over 11 landen. Vanavond hier in Den Haag strijden 18 landen om de grote prijs van het Eurovisie Songfestival 1976. De deelnemers zullen worden begeleid door het Metropoolorkest, dat u al tijdens de ouverture heeft kunnen horen, onder leiding van Jan Stulen. Voor de liedjes zal het orkest geleid worden door dirigenten afkomstig uit de deelnemende landen.
Corrie Brocken has already appeared three times as a singer in this event. In 1956, together with Jetty Pearl, she represented the Netherlands at the first Eurovision Song Contest, which was held in Lugano. The following year, she was the first Dutch singer to win the song contest in Frankfurt. Finally, she took part once more in 1958 in the first contest to take place in Holland at Hilversum.
Mesdames et messieurs, bonsoir. Depuis La Haye aux Pays-Bas, je souhaite la bienvenue à 450
Well, all these heady successes of hers launched her into a very successful career, which included many recording highlights, such as the Dutch version of Milord, which was a major hit for her. She appeared on many TV programs in the Netherlands and in Germany between 67 and 71. Abruptly, in 1971, however, she announced her retirement from show business. At present, she's studying law, and I understand she expects to be called to the bar next year. It took a great deal of persuading on the part of the producer of the show to convince her that the long layoff, 5 years it is since she was on television, would not adversely affect her handling of the show tonight.
Fixé par tirage au sort et tout cela sous les auspices de l'UER. Je souhaite les jurys qui vont juger tout à l'heure quelle sera la chanson gagnante de cette année un bon jugement. Ladies and gentlemen, good evening. From The Hague in the Netherlands, I say hello to 450 millions of viewers in 33 countries and to 80 millions of listeners in 11 countries. Tonight here in The Hague, 18 countries have gathered to contest the Grand Prix of the Eurovision Song Contest 1976. The singers will be accompanied by the Metropole Orchestra, which you have already heard performing the opening tune conducted by Jan Stulen. For the songs, the orchestra will be directed by conductors from the participating countries, and the order of songs has been established by lot, and all this under the auspices of the EBU, the European Broadcasting Union. I wish the juries who have to judge which one will be Europe's best song this year lots of success, and may I invite you now to listen with us to the first song, the English song by the Brotherhood of Man.
So here we go on the 21st Eurovision Song Contest. 18 songs, some good, some plain bad, and some mediocre. Save Your Kisses for Me by Brotherhood of Man representing Great Britain. It used to be thought that being drawn first was a disadvantage, but Teach-In disproved that theory last year with Ding Ding A Dong. This is a typical strong British entry from the puppet on the string, boom, bang, a bang school. Mind you, its pedigree is fairly impressive. Number one in Britain, Luxembourg, and a few other countries as well. It was written by Tony Hiller, one of England's best-known record producers and conductors, and two members of the group, Martin Lee and Lee Sheridan. Tony Hiller formed Brotherhood of Man 3 years ago, and since then they've enjoyed more popularity on the continent, in fact, than they have at home in Britain. Conducting for Britain is Alan Ainsworth, who's also well-known as a musical director, and among the many hits he's arranged, was Shirley Bassey's Big Spender. So, Brotherhood of Man for Britain.
Though it hurts to go away, it's impossible to stay, but there's one thing I must say before I go. I love you.
I love you.
You know, I'll be thinking of you in most everything I do. Time is moving on, and I really should be gone, but you keep me hanging on for one more smile. I love you,
I love you,
for a while. In a cute little way, will you promise that you'll say
don't cry, honey, don't
'cause you know I'll have to say that I've got to work each day, and that's why I go away. But I count the seconds till I'm home with you. I love you. Won't you save them up for me? Your
kisses for me. Save all your kisses for me. Bye-bye, baby, bye-bye. Don't cry, honey, don't cry.
Walk out the door, but I'll soon be back for more.
Kisses for me. Save all your kisses for me.
No, you've got to save your
kisses for me. Send all your kisses for me. Bye-bye, baby, bye-bye. Don't cry, honey, don't cry.
You save them for me, even though you're only three.
Man there for England and Scotland and Wales and even Northern Ireland. Those ladies will be coming out at the end of each of the songs presenting flowers to the singers, so rather nice touch. We move on now to song two, Jumbo Jumbo, sung by Peter Thue and Mark for Switzerland. If this trio looks familiar, it could be because they represented their country in Dublin in the 1970 contest. They're the most popular group in their country and are invariably chosen to represent the Swiss at major worldwide music festivals. The girl, Sue, is American, and although over the years she has lost her American accent, she intersperses her conversation with late 50s slang terms like, man, dig that crazy beat. Peter, the clean-shaven one, is also the composer of the song. He's had a classical music education and spent 3 years in Wales studying psychology. Chap with the carefully trimmed beard is Mark Dietrich. He's the oldest member of the group and is a multi-instrumentalist. He says he can play about 12 instruments reasonably well. Somebody asked him, could he play them all at the same time? So he promptly switched on a cassette tape of himself doing just that. The conductor is Mario Robbiani. Jumbo Jumbo, sung by Peter Thue and Mark for Switzerland.
The birds have known the old man for many years. His eyes have seen so much and look so mild. He's up at 4 and early every morning. He feeds them and feels happy like a child. Once he was a clown in the arena. People said the best that ever was. Now they call him good old Jumbo Jumbo. But in his dreams he still hears the applause. Hey, hey, hey,
hey, hey, Jumbo Jumbo.
Sometimes you can see him on the sidewalk with little boys and girls around his feet. When Jumbo Jumbo plays his barrel organ, children call it circus in the street. Suddenly his eyes reflect emotion. In Jumbo's mind the line again. He's back on stage and all the kids are laughing.
Jumbo Jumbo.
Jumbo from Peter, Sue and Mark, representing Switzerland. Song 3 is called Sing Sang Song. It's sung by the Les Humphrey Singers, and it's representing West Germany. The lyricist almost certainly eliminated himself from the race for the Nobel Prize for Literature with the lyrics of the first verse. Sing, sang, song, sing, sang, song, sha-la-la. Sing, sang, song, sing, sang, song, sha-la-la, and so on. So mind you, when a song with lyrics like when you're feeling all right, everything is up tight, try to sing a song that goes ding, ding, a dong, could win the title for Holland last year. His chances of a Eurovision winner are not so remote. The Les Humphrey Singers have amassed a total of 20 gold records in their five-year career. There are 12 members of the group, but the rules allow only a maximum of 6 performers on stage. So among the 6 on stage is a red-headed young man from Clonmel named David O'Brien. You'll see him when they're singing on the extreme right of your screen. Les Humphreys himself, in fact, claims Irish ancestry. He says his parents were born in Uri. Les is not singing tonight. He said he's wielding the baton in the orchestra pit. So the Les Humphrey Singers singing now for Germany. If certainly personality plus. The Les Humphrey singers there, singing sing-sang songs for West Germany. Song 4, this is Emor Shalom for Israel, and it's sung by the Chocolate Girls. What a boon this trio is to the Army Recruiting Office in Israel, because these are three of the finest fighting men in Israel, and as fine a body of men you'll seldom see. They joined the Army on the same day, began singing together almost immediately, teamed up with the entertainment group, and remained together when they were honorably discharged. Although they're undoubtedly successful and happy nowadays, I feel if you look deeply into their eyes, you'll detect a certain warm light of reminiscence as their blood stirs with yearning for the good old army days of square bashing, reveille, boot polishing, and peeling potatoes. Yes, to me they look like three typical 30-year men who would really prefer to be singing around the old campfire tonight rather than on this great stage. The conductor is also the composer, Matty Caspi. Chocolate Girls for Israel. Chocolate Girls singing for Israel. And so to Song 5, Chanson pour ceux qui s'aiment, sung by Jürgen Marcus for Luxembourg. And a grand little fellow this is, too. He has a set of teeth that would dazzle an Eskimo, and they're all his own. Someone was ungracious enough to ask him that very question at his press conference. The lad never flinched. He even challenged the questioner to try and pull out any one of his teeth. Mercifully, however, the questioner backed down. Jürgen is the pin-up of the young girls who were permanently stationed outside the theater, and he would indeed appear to be worthy of their idolatry. A large middle-aged man carrying a little brown box is forever at his shoulder. The box contains two bottles of milk and two glasses, and whenever Jürgen feels thirsty, he finds somewhere quiet where no one will notice him. like the foyer of the theater or the press room, and has the man pour him a glassful. As one would expect, however, he is a very charming lad and a first-class singer. The song is composed by Zena Boogie and Fred Jay and Jack White, and the conductor is Yoplait. Jürgen Mark is there, singing for Luxembourg, and indeed he could well be there or thereabouts at the end of that one. So we come to song 6 now. This is representing Belgium, and it's Judy & Co, sung by Pierre Rapsat. Pierre is 27 years of age, was born in Brussels, and is one of the composers of the song. He started out as a rock singer, faithfully imitating the Rolling Stones approach. After 6 years of changing groups and generally making little progress, he decided to write his own songs and try to develop an individual style. It would appear he was very successful in the changeover because he is now regarded as one of the most creative composers in Belgium and France. He's a gifted musician and on his first album played every instrument himself. The other composer, Eric Van Hulser, is Belgium's top record producer, and he is also a singer of some note and speaks half a dozen languages fluently. The conductor for Belgium is a man who specializes in composing film soundtracks, Michel Berneuf. Pierre Rapsat for Belgium.
June. que la soirée s'achève. Judy, Judy, oh, the shiny. Judy, Judy, oh, the mari.
Version Judy and so. And so we come to song 7, and this is where Red Hurley takes the stage in front of his biggest audience ever. Temperamentally, Red is ideally suited to an occasion like this. He's a placid, easygoing fellow who, although he insists he does suffer from nerves, betrays few signs of tension. However, the composer Brendan Graham says he's betraying enough tension for both of them. Brendan and his nearest and dearest are all in the theatre this evening, willing Master Hurley on. Well, at least to a good placing, if not victory, anyway. So there we are. Red has begun composing songs himself, and it's quite possible that he and Brendan Graham will team up and write a few numbers for Red's new album. He can't get through on the phone either. The girls in the backing group this evening with Red are Pat Riley, Lola, and Nicola Kerr, and this evening Red is wearing his green suit, and the girls are wearing green dresses. Conductor is the familiar figure of Noel Keelahan. So, wishing Red Hurley every success, Noel Keelahan raises his hand for Ireland.
And all the nights are long, then all my thoughts run on to you. When the lonely silence calls, when I walk through empty halls, then all my thoughts run on to you. And when they linger for a while, you come and touch me with your tender smile. And when your love was all my world, my my days, my life you were. Then all the songs were songs of you. I tasted well of sweet success. Nothing touched me that was second.
There, really good performance there by Red Hurley, and there's a tremendous reaction here in the hall for that song. And Brendan and Graham will no doubt be delighted with Red's interpretation of the song. We move on now to song 8. The party's over now, and it's sung by Sandra Raymer for the Netherlands. The turn now of the home team. The Dutch entry usually finishes in the top half dozen. They've won the contest 4 times, record equaled only by Luxembourg and France. This year, their entry is felt by some Dutch people to be a little lower in standards than usual, but it remains to be seen. Their singer, Sandra Raymer, however, is an excellent performer. She represented Holland in the Eurovision 3 years ago as half of the singing duo Sandra and Andrish. She was born in Indonesia and has lived in Holland since she was 2. She was a recording star when still a 15-year-old schoolgirl. Composer Harry van Hemert is the man who wrote How Do You Do? For Malcolm McNeil at the 74 contest. And Harry van Hoff is conducting for Holland for the 4th year in succession. The party's over now for the Netherlands.
But not to me. I wonder, am I really dreaming?
Timer singing The Party's Over Now for Holland. And predictably, getting a very good reception. Song 9, Mata Hari, sung by Anna Karina Ström for Norway. Anna Karina is making her third appearance in the Eurovision final. In both 73 and 74, she represented Norway as a member of the Bendik Singers. She is married to the conductor and composer of the song, Frode Tingnes. Frode is generally regarded as Norway's top musician and has his own jazz quintet. Anna Karina is very much the darling of the press here. Her picture adorns almost every edition of the newspapers, and she's receiving even more publicity than the Dutch girl. The ensemble in which she appears tonight, by the way, so impressed the members of the orchestra at the dress rehearsal that they rose to their feet whistling and cheering. It's gold brocade with matching glasses and headband. There he is, conductor and husband, Frode Tingnes. Anna Karina, Norway.
There are days I just can't make it, even though I try to fake it. When I wish that I could take it, turn a page and start anew. In a world with no tomorrow, I could throw away my sorrow and pretend you'd let me borrow.
Singing Mata Hari for Norway. The tenth song coming up now, Panayamu, Panayamu, sung by Marisa Koch for Greece. Marisa is in fact the composer as well as singer. She was studying music in Athens when the government was overthrown. She was forced to flee the country and settled for 3 years in London before returning to her homeland in 1970. She originated an unusual musical combination, singing to drum accompaniment only. It proved very successful and became something of a cult. She's regarded in her own country as a female Demis Roussos. an appendage which musically might be acceptable, but physically could perhaps induce the occasional throb of resentment from Miss Cork, who is admittedly also a person of ample proportions. What a voice, though. Wait until you hear her. Recently, Marisa Koch completed a four-week concert tour of the Soviet Union. The conductor for Greece is Mike Douzakis. Marisa Koch sings now for Greece. That then, Marisa Koch singing her own composition for Greece. Song 11, Pump, Pump for Finland, performed by Freddie and Friends. From the same country that produced Sibelius, we are about to hear the ensuing lyric. Let your hip go hippity bump bump, that's the way we dance till we die, aye, aye, aye. Let your hip go hippity bump bump, give me shivers all down my spine, aye, aye, aye. Poor Sibelius must be doing handsprings in his grave. Mind you, worst lyrics that I've said before have won. The person who actually wrote that is the large chap with the moustache. He's Freddy, all 6 feet 5 inches, 17 cuddly stones. He's a superstar in Finland. He's written innumerable songs, and all of them have made Finland's top 10. Freddy took part in the Eurovision in Vienna in 1967, the year we were second, with Sean Dunphy's song. But that time, purely as a singer. This time, he is composer as well. The conductor is the pop popular and much respected Otis Runa. Freddie and friends now sing Pump Pump for Finland. Freddy there doing his thing with his friends and representing Finland. And the girls still haven't a bruise to show for it. So we move on now to song 12, Sobran las Palabras, sung for Spain by Braulio. Braulio is yet another of the singer-composer combinations which are featuring more and more in this contest. He's 29 and was born in the Canary Islands. His musical education, however, started and was nurtured in England. In 1969, he arrived there and found himself becoming involved in folk music. His experiences in England had quite an effect on him, and he says that while there, his vision of music and the world in general really changed. He returned to Spain and is now one of that country's top stars. He insists upon recording only his own songs, not that he feels other composers are inferior. He just needs to know the meaning of a song. A number of people have mentioned the physical resemblance, by the way, between himself and Greg Hurley. Conductor for Spain is Juan Bergant. Braulio sings for Spain.
Hasta sobran las palabras cuando se trata de hablar sencillamente de amor y prefiero esa frase desgastada que a nada suena en mi voz. Ya sé que tú puedes creer que a mí me falta el interés, pero a veces las promesas más fervientes solo tratan de ocultar que está muriendo el amor. De amor, y el gesto que hasta pasa inadvertido puede ser más importante que un juramento ante Dios. Mi ausencia.
Representing Spain. Song 13, Noi lo rivivremo di nuovo, for Italy, sung by Romina Power and Albano. If those dark, clearly defined features of Romina strike a chord in her memory, it's probably because she's the daughter of the film actor, the late Tyrone Power. It was said that Tyrone Power had Irish family connections, so I suppose we can claim some affinity with this American-born, Italy-domiciled girl. She was born in Los Angeles, speaks five languages, and enjoys deep-sea diving. Al Bano is her husband, and they have two beautiful children. Al has appeared in seven films, has toured the world as a singer, and collects butterflies. The composer is Detto Mariano, and the conductor, Maurizio Fabrizio, is a classical guitarist, and although only 24, is regarded as one of the most promising musical prospects in Italy.
Yeah. son pochi, se vivessi di nuovo io te sempre riceverei.
Well, she seems very fond of Flumino Power and Albano singing there for Italy. Song 14, My Little World for Austria, sung by Waterloo and Robson. Waterloo is the tall, dashing one, and Robson is the proud bearer of a Prussian-looking moustache. I asked them separately about their names. It appears they didn't seem likely to scale the pinnacles of show business as the Edwards brothers, so they decided on separate names. They chose Waterloo simply because it sounded international, but they disagreed about the origins of Robinson. Waterloo told me the song Mrs. Robinson was popular at the time, but Robinson said he saw it on the bottle of barley water. Their biggest record success to date was called Hollywood, which sold over 1 million copies around the world and was released in Britain under the title Midnight Movie. The composer Gerhard Heinzer wrote the soundtrack to the film Julia, and he was duly nominated for an Oscar. And the conductor is Eric Kleinschuster.
Trees are things money doesn't buy, but sunshine brings. Oh, how beautiful that it can be when you say the one you love is me. But everything is fine. I'm sure that my love is mine. I don't need to be a millionaire. Money doesn't make a love affair. Here we are, free to go. That's what makes me love you so. I just love.
Waterloo and Robinson there, representing Austria. Four more songs to go. This is song 15, and it's Portugal. Uma Flor de Verde Pinho, a green pine flower, that's the title, and it's sung by Carlos de Carmo. Carlos is arguably the greatest living exponent of the traditional Portuguese music form, the Fado. Recently, the Fado has been subjected to quite an amount of commercial exploitation. Carlos resents this exploitation and is doing all he can to bring it back to its original purity. Mind you, he doesn't sing only Fado. He is an excellent interpreter of the songs of Jacques Brel, and he also sings many of the songs made famous by Sinatra. The composers, José Niza and Manuel Alegre, are deeply involved in politics. Both are deputies of the Socialist Party in the Constituent Assembly. The shamrock, believe it or not, gets a mention in this song. The line is, there's no boat, no wheat, no shamrock, no words for the song to be sung. The conductor is Philo Krasman.
Eu podia chamar-te pátria, dar-te o mais lindo nome português. Podia dar-te um nome de rainha, que este amor é de Pedro Corirês. Mas não há forma, não há verso, não há lei. Para este fogo, amor, para este rio, como dizer o coração fora do peito, meu amor, transbordou que eu sei na vida. Gostar de ti é um problema que não digo, que não há taça, amor, para este rio, não há guitarras nem cantar de amigo. Não há flor, não há flor de verde pinho. Não há barco nem trigo, não há trigo. Não há palavras para dizer esta canção. Gostar de ti é um poema que não escrevo. Que há um rio sem leito dele, sem coração. Mas não há forma, não há verso, não há leito. Para este fogo, amor, para este rio, como dizer um coração fora do peito? Meu amor, transbordou que eu sei navio. Gostar de ti é um poema que não digo, que não há tanto amor. Para este vinho, não há guitarras, nem cantar de abrigo. Não há flor, não há flor de verde pinho.
A certain degree of dignity to the occasion, Carlos de Carmo, representing Portugal. Song 16 is from Monaco, Toi la musique et moi, sung by Marie-Christie. Again, another of the favorites for the title. Marie-Christie is an Italian girl who has lived in Paris for the past 3 years, having lived previously in Germany and Luxembourg. She apparently is a very shy girl, but the Monegasque delegation maintains that she lights up like a fire when she appears on stage. Next week, she's scheduled to appear on French TV in a major musical produced by Gilbert Bécaud. Marie will, of course, be hoping to repeat Séverine's success for Monaco in the Dublin Eurovision. The composers of her song tonight are a formidable trio indeed. Between them, they've written for Marie Chevalier, Mireille Mathieu, Caterina Valente, and many other well-known names. The composers' names are Gilbert Sinoé and Georges and Michel Costa. The conductor is the man who conducted for Anne-Marie David when she won for Luxembourg 3 years ago, Raymond Donnet. So, Marie Christie sings for Monaco.
Dans tes yeux, dans ta chambre là-haut, tu t'ennuies. Oh, tu t'endors comme un clou malheureux. Laisse-la te remuer et tes gens toujours pressés. Laisse-la tomber tes soins et suis-moi. Si tu veux nourrir en toi la musique et moi, plus simplement.
Singing there for Monaco. Song 17 is from France. Un, deux, trois, sung by Catherine Ferry. France, although winners four times in all, haven't come out on top since sharing the title with three other countries in 1969, and they're very anxious do well this year. All of these little film inserts, by the way, were filmed by the same film crew from the Dutch TV service. It took them 4 weeks to visit all 18 countries. Catherine Ferry is 22, and her career has been very varied indeed. She started as a ballet dancer, then joined a professional orchestra as a violinist. She's an exceptional ice skater, thinks Paul Newman is the greatest thing since bottled onions, and hates horror movies. Her composer, Jean-Paul Carat, describes himself as an open human being who doesn't believe in the division between man and artist, which is no doubt very commendable if a little confusing. The man who is conducting for France is Tony Rallo, who has written a number of film scores. So Catherine Ferry singing for France.
C'est d'être aimé de toi, d'aller chanter, la 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 la. sort of puppet on a string sound there, being very well received here. The French entry sung by Catherine Perry. This is the final song. It's from Yugoslavia. I Cannot Hide My Pain, sung by Ambassadori. A very vibrant group, this. They formed in 1969. At the time, they were full-time musicians with the Sarajevo Orchestra. All the male members of the group play at least six musical instruments, and three of them compose and arrange all the tunes they perform. Yvette, the girl, is the only member of the group with no musical training at all. Then she's supplying the voice and the glamour, so no one is complaining. The group is very popular in Russia, and last year made three extensive tours there. Last year, their record, Land of Mine, was voted Yugoslavia's record of the year. The conductor, making his second Eurovision appearance, is Kesad Armatalic. We'll rejoin in about 5 minutes for the voting. So, we'll see you then.
And welcome to part two of our coverage of the 21st Eurovision Song Contest. You join us here in the Eurovision Jury Studio, where we've just finished voting for our 17 countries. We can't vote for ourselves, of course. Now, the jury has 11 members picked from the public at large, with a chairman appointed by RTE. In fact, he tabulates the score. He gives the result to me, and in my capacity as jury secretary, I pass on the result with my good friend James Logan here. Pass the result on to The Hague and into the final computer to Miss Corrie Brocken over there. Let's meet our chairman, first of all, before we meet our jury. He's from RTE Radio's Live Music Department. He's Ennis MacDonald. Let's go over to you, Ennis. Perhaps you might give us some idea of how the jury system works, the scores.
Well, Brendan, each member of the jury must vote for every song except the national entry, of course. They will award from a minimum of one vote to a maximum of five votes. The votes are then tabulated, and the song that receives the highest number of votes is awarded 12 points. The song which receives the second highest number of votes is awarded 10 points, the third highest awarded 8, the fourth 7, 6, 5, 4, right down, so that the top 10 songs will receive points in Eurovision.
Seems a very fair system, ma'am. What happens if we get a tie?
Well, if we have a local tie, it's decided on a show of hands amongst our own jury.
Well, in point of fact, we've cheated slightly that because we just had a tie here twice in our local jury. We've gone through the voting. We've actually cast a vote. We know the result when Ennis actually finishes. And, of course, our jury members can't hear how the voting is going until such time as I've called in our vote to The Hague. Let's first of all meet our jury right now, and let's go first of all to the far left, right across the studio. John Duffy, welcome.
How do you do, Brian?
How did you think Red did? Very well, I think.
Oh, I expect him to get very high.
You think so?
Yeah, he's
done very
well.
Would you take a wager on that?
I would indeed, yes.
Top five?
10.
Top 10, okay, that's fair enough. You're a taxi driver.
I am indeed, yes.
Okay, well, good luck to you. Beside him is Anne Stafford. Anne, you're a student radiographer. Yes. Did you spot the winner, do you think?
I'm not so sure, but I hope so. It's very high standard, though.
Were you hard pushed to get an out-and-out winner?
We had two favourites, really, among them.
Yeah, okay. Well, beside Anne is Cecile Cassidy. Cecile, you were, I know, a childcare social worker up to now. You've changed functions all of a sudden.
That's right, Jess. Working in a boutique now on Stephen's Green.
Some difference, isn't it?
It is indeed, yeah.
Beside Cess is Tom O'Neill. Tom, you're from Limerick. You're in the garage business, I hear.
That's right.
How's trade?
Quite good.
Okay. Colette O'Neill, you're a housewife, are you?
I am, yeah.
How did you think the songs went generally?
Standard very high, very good indeed, very pleased with it all, yeah.
Great, great. Kevin Dolan, you're from Ballinasloe in County Galway. What was your impression of the song?
Very high standard indeed. Mm-hmm. And very hard to make a decision on who was the outright winner, of course. Death.
Yeah. Well, you can hear Jimmy beside me going through all sorts of technical problems. Let's go straight on to our next jury members, Rita Flood. Rita, you're a secretary and a housewife.
Yes.
Is it hard combining the two?
Not really, no.
Not really. I hope you enjoyed yourself tonight. Anyway, let's go pass on straight away to Edwin Finnegan. You're in the pub business, I believe.
That's correct.
And you're also in the commercial line of things. Do you like that particular end of things?
Oh, yes, I do, yes.
The man beside you is Tony Guerin. Tony looks like, and in fact is, a real-life detective. We have scrutineers all over the place, but in fact, we don't think we need your services in an official capacity. Thank you for coming along, Tony, anyway.
Thank you, Ben.
And beside Tony is Pamela Dowling. Pamela, you are the Dracules of the jury.
Yes.
You're in the blood bank.
Yes.
Is that travelling around the country a lot?
Well, it's travelling around most of the time, yes. We go to 22 counties.
Mm-hmm. Did you find it hard to pick your favourite from the songs?
Very hard, very high standard, yeah.
Mm. Did you, well, don't tell us now, did you jump for one or the other, or did you have a
few
favorites?
Well, two in particular, but I'm not saying which.
Okay, well, thank you, Pamela. And beside you is Joe Carroll. Joe, tell me about yourself. You're from Ballyfermot.
I'm a student, plain ordinary.
Plain ordinary. What's your late teens direction?
18.
18, okay. Well, we have half a panel under, half a panel over 25. And that's a rough idea of what they look like, the people we actually make up our votes here for The Hague. I'll transmit these to the Hague, to our compere over there, very, very shortly indeed, and we will see how we go. We return you now to The Hague, and our commentator in The Hague for you is Mr. Mike Murphy.
Ja, dames en heren, we zijn weer terug in de grote zaal van het congresgebouw in Den Haag. De stemmen zijn geteld en we zullen contact op gaan nemen met de deelnemende landen om de juryuitslagen te vernemen. En dit alles gebeurt onder het wakend en toeziend oog van de officiële vertegenwoordiger van de EBU, de heer Clifford Brown, geassisteerd door Joke Bis.
Well, away? We heard a few numbers from the Dutch Spring College Band. That's Clifford Brown, the scrutineer, being introduced.
Mesdames et messieurs, nous sommes de retour dans la grande salle du
Congrès. Well, now let me explain the procedure should the voting result in a tie. The countries which are not involved in the tie cast their vote for whichever of the songs involved the majority of the members of the jury prefers. In other words, if over half the jury members vote for a song, then That's the one nominated, but of course, everybody hopes it won't result in a tie.
We are back in the big hall now, ladies and gentlemen, of the Congresgebouw in The Hague. The votes have been counted, and we are going to contact now the participating countries to hear the jury's decision. The scoring will be scrutinized by the official representative of the EBU, Mr. Clifford Brown, assisted by Joke Vis. And I'm now calling the first jury in the United Kingdom. Hello, United Kingdom. May I have your votes, please?
Yes, indeed, Corrie. Very good evening to you. The results of the United Kingdom jury here. First of all, Switzerland, 12 points.
Switzerland, 12 points. La Suisse, 12 points.
That's the maximum number
Israel,
of votes.
6 points.
Israel, 6 points. Israel, 6 points.
Belgium, 7 points.
Belgium, 7 points. La Belgique, 7 points.
Ireland, 10 points.
Ireland, 10 points.
Oh, that's
Irlanda,
not a bad start. Finland, 2 points.
Finland, 2 points. Finland, 2 points.
Spain, 3 points.
Spain, 3 points. Espagne, 3 points.
Italy, 1 point.
Italy, 1 point. Italy, 1 point.
Austria, 4 points.
Austria, 4 points. Autriche, 4 points.
Monaco, 5 points.
Monaco, 5 points. Monaco, 5 points.
And France, 8 points.
France, 8 points. La France, 8 points.
And that completes the voting of the United Kingdom jury.
Thank you.
Well, what a good start Britain gave us.
And may I now call Switzerland. Good evening, Switzerland. Can you hear me? And may I have your votes, please? Hello, Switzerland. Are you there? Please.
Oui, allô La Haye, ici Berne. Bonsoir La Haye. Voici les résultats du vote du jury suisse. Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points. United Kingdom, 12 points.
Allemagne, 2 points.
Allemagne, 2 points. Germany, 2 points.
Israël, 7 points.
Israël, 7 points. Israël, 7 points.
Belgique, 6 points.
Belgique, 6 points. Belgium, 6 points.
Pays-Bas, 4 points.
Pays-Bas, 4 points. Netherlands, 4 points.
So, no votes for us there from Switzerland.
Italie, 8 points. Italy, 8 points.
Autriche, 3 points.
Autriche, 3 points. Austria, 3 points.
Monaco, 5 points.
Monaco, 5 points. Monaco, 5
France,
points.
10 points.
France, 10 points. France,
Yougoslavie, 1 point.
10 points. Just a minute, will you repeat the last one, please? Repeat Yugoslavia, please. One up. Yugoslavia, 1 point. Yugoslavia, 1 point.
1 point.
1 point, merci, ok.
France, in the lead.
Le vote du jury suisse. Bonsoir, Lay.
Bonsoir. And now I'm calling Germany. Guten Abend, Germany. May I have your votes, please?
Guten Abend, Den Haag.
Guten Abend, hoor.
Now that's Frankfurt calling, and he has the results of the German jury. United Kingdom, 8 points.
United Kingdom, 8 points. Royaume-Uni, 8 points.
Switzerland, 5 points.
Switzerland, 5 points. La Suisse, 5 points.
Israel, 3 points.
Israel, 3 points. Israel, 3 points.
Ireland, 1 point.
Ireland, 1 point. Irlande, 1 point.
Netherlands, 4 points.
Netherlands, 4 points. Les Pays-Bas, 4 points.
Finland, 6 points.
Finland, 6 points. Finland, 6 points.
Austria, 10 points.
Austria, 10 points. Autriche, 10 points.
Monaco, 7 points.
Monaco, 7 points. Monaco, 7 points.
France, 12 points.
France, 12 points. La France, 12 points.
Yugoslavia, 2 points.
Yugoslavia, 2 points. Yugoslavie, 2 points.
That's a very sizable lead for France.
Vielen Dank, auf Wiedersehen. Israel. Good evening, Israel. May I have your votes, please?
Hello, The Hague. Hello, The Hague. Guten Abend, Jerusalem calling. Here are the results of the Israeli jury. United Kingdom, 12 points.
United Kingdom, 12 points. Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Switzerland, 4 points.
Switzerland, 4 points. La Suisse, 4 points.
Belgium, 1 point.
Belgium, 1 point. La Belgique, 1 point.
Ireland, 3 points.
Ireland, 3 points. Irlande, 3 points.
The Netherlands, 8 points.
The Netherlands, 8 points. Les Pays-Bas, 8 points.
Finland, 6 points.
Finland, 6 points. Finland, 6 points.
Italy, 2 points.
Italy, 2 points. Italy, 2 points.
Austria, 10 points.
Austria, 7 points. Autriche, pardon?
10 points.
Austria, 10 points. Autriche, 10 points.
Monaco, 7 points.
Monaco, 7 points. Monaco, 7 points.
France, 5 points.
France, 5 points. La France, 5 points.
And that completes the points.
Well, Austria came into the race there, but Luxembourg, that Jürgen Marcus, has had no vote so far, and now Luxembourg are voting. Catherine Selly, France.
Your votes, please.
Oui, ici Luxembourg, bonsoir Lay, bonsoir Corrie.
Bonsoir.
Voici les résultats du vote du jury luxembourgeois. Royaume-Uni, 8 points.
Royaume-Uni, 8 points. United Kingdom, 8 points.
Suisse, 1 point.
Suisse, 1 point. Switzerland, 1 point.
Allemagne, 2 points.
Allemagne, 2 points. Germany, 2 points.
Israël, 7 points.
Israël, 6 points.
7 points. 7
Israël,
points.
7 points.
Yes, that's right.
Okay, thank you. Israël, 7 points.
Irlande, 3 points.
Irlande, 3 points. Ireland, 3 points.
Pays-Bas, 4 points.
Pays-Bas, 4 points. The Netherlands, 4 points.
Lots of encouragement
points.
For the Netherlands.
Autriche,
they get a few points.
Autriche, 5 points. Austria, 5 points.
Portugal, 6 points.
Portugal, 6 points.
Well, Portugal appear on the board.
Portugal,
6 points
6
up.
Points.
Monaco, 12 points.
Oh,
Monaco,
12 points.
12 points.
12 points from Monaco.
Monaco, 12 points.
France, 10 points.
Oh,
France,
an excellent point for
points.
France.
La France,
10 points
10
for France.
Points, France, 10 points.
Cela termine le vote du jury luxembourgeois. Bonsoir, Corrie.
Bonsoir, au revoir.
The Brotherhood of Man team. Looking
Belgium.
Very happy as well,
Hello,
they might.
Belgium, can you hear me and may I have your voice, your votes, please?
Yes, of course. Allô, La Haye, ici Bruxelles. Voici les résultats du jury belge. Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
12
Royaume-Uni,
points for Britain.
12 points.
12
United
points.
Kingdom, 12 points.
Suisse, 7 points.
Suisse, 7 points. Switzerland, 7 points.
Allemagne, 1 point.
Allemagne, 1 point. Germany, 1 point.
Israël, 5 points.
Will you repeat Israel, please?
Israël, 5 points. 5 points.
Israël, 5 points. 5 points. Thank you.
Luxembourg. 6 points.
Luxembourg, 6 points.
Ah, yes.
Luxembourg,
Luxembourg get on the board.
Points.
That should bring that smile to Jürgen Marcus' face.
4 points.
No marks at all for Ireland from Belgium.
4 points.
La Grèce, 2 points.
La Grèce.
Get a couple of points.
Greece, 2 points.
That's Marisa Koch.
L'Autriche, 3 points.
L'Autriche, 3 points. Austria, 3 points.
Monaco, 8 points.
Monaco, 8 points. Monaco, 8 points.
La France, 10 points.
La
10
France,
points for France.
10 points. France, 10 points.
Et ça s'y termine les points attribués par le jury belge. Merci.
Bonsoir,
and the only country now without a point is Norway. That was Matahari.
Good evening, Ireland. May I have your votes, please?
Guten Abend, Corrie. Guten Abend, Den Haag. Here from Dublin is the result of the Irish jury. United Kingdom, 3 points.
United Kingdom,
at
3 points.
Oh, goes up.
Royaume-Uni, 3 points. I'm sorry. Go on, please.
Switzerland, 1 point.
Switzerland, 1 point. La Suisse, 1 point.
Israel, 4 points.
Israel, 4 points. Israel, 4 points.
Luxembourg, 6 points.
Luxembourg, 6 points. Luxembourg, 6 points.
Netherlands, 2 points.
Netherlands, 2 points. Les Pays-Bas, 2 points.
Finland, 5 points.
Finland, 5 points. Finland, 5 points.
Italy, 12 points.
Italy, 12 points. Italy, 12 points.
Austria, 10 points.
Austria, 10 points. Autriche, 10 points.
Monaco, 8 points.
Monaco, 8 points. Monaco, 8 points.
And France, 7 points.
France, 7 points, you said. Thank you,
that
yes. La
and
France, 7 points.
I beg your pardon.
It's all right.
The voting of the Irish jury.
Well,
thank
it
you.
Looks
good
as
night.
If we could well have...
the Netherlands. Hello, Netherlands.
Decided in the favor of somebody.
May I have your votes, please?
You are yourself of the Dutch jury. United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
Switzerland, 6 points.
Switzerland, 6 points. La Suisse, 6 points.
Israel, 2 points.
Israel, 2 points. Israel, 2 points.
Luxembourg, 5 points.
Luxembourg, 5 points. Luxembourg, 5 points.
Belgium, 4 points.
Belgium, 4 points. La Belgique, 4 points.
Norway, 3 points.
Hey, Norway, 3 points.
Excellent. Good.
Norway,
that's Matahari. That's the sound that was done by Anna-Karina Ström.
Finland, 1 point.
Finland, 1 point. Finland, 1 point.
Austria, 7 points.
Austria, 7 points. Autriche, 7 points.
Monaco, 8 points.
Monaco, 8 points. Monaco, 8 points.
France, 12 points.
France, 12 points. La France, 12 points. Woo.
And that completes the points of the Dutch jury.
Dank u wel, Netherlands. Norway. Hello, Norway. Can I have your votes, please?
Hello, Mark. Also calling.
Hello.
Good evening. Here are the results of the Norwegian jury. United Kingdom, 12 points.
United Kingdom, 12 points. Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Switzerland, 10 points.
Switzerland, 10 points. La Suisse, 10 points.
Israel, 7 points.
Israel, 7 points. Israel, 7 points.
Belgium, 6 points.
Belgium, 6 points. La Belgique, 6 points.
Netherlands, 1 point.
Netherlands, 1 point. Les Pays-Bas, 1 point.
Finland, 4 points.
Finland, 4 points. Finland, 4 points.
Italy, 3 points.
Italy, 3 points. Italy, 3 points.
Austria, 2 points.
Austria, 2 points. Autriche, 3 points.
Monaco, 5 points.
Monaco, 5 points. Monaco, 5 points.
France, 8 points.
France, 8 points. La France, 8 points.
And that completes the voting of the Norwegian jury. Good
Thank
night.
You very much. Good night.
So there we are, halfway through the voting now,
Greece.
And it looks as if it's a four-horse race already. We look as if we're out of ourselves at present. France, Britain, Monaco, and Austria are meeting.
Royaume-Uni,
12 points.
Royaume-Uni, 12 points. United Kingdom, 12 points.
La Suisse, 2 points.
La Suisse, 2 points. Switzerland, 2 points.
L'Irlande, 8 points.
Irlande, 8 points.
8 points.
Ireland, 8 points.
Les Pays-Bas, 7 points.
Les Pays-Bas, 7 points. Netherlands, 7 points.
L'Espagne, 1 point.
L'Espagne, 1 point. Spain, 1 point.
L'Italie, 10 points.
L'Italie, 10 points. Italy, 10 points.
L'Autriche, 6 points.
L'Autriche, 6 points. Austria, 6 points.
Le Portugal, 4 points.
Portugal, 4 points. Portugal, 4 points.
La France, 5 points.
La France, 5 points.
And no points
France,
there for
five
Monaco.
Points.
La Yougoslavie, 3 points.
Yougoslavie, 1 point. Yougoslavia, 1 point.
3 points.
La Yougoslavie, 3 points. 3 points. Thank you very much, Greece. Bye-bye.
Britain leading by 2 points now from France.
Finland. Good evening, Finland. Can you hear me and may I have your votes, please?
I do hear you quite well. Good evening. This
good evening.
The jury of Helsinki and we are ready to give our results. United Kingdom, 10 points.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
Switzerland, 7 points.
Switzerland, 7 points. La Suisse, 7 points.
Israel, 8 points.
Israel, 8 points. Israel, 8 points.
Belgium, 12 points.
Belgium, 12 points.
Belgium,
La Belgique,
12 points.
12 points.
And then Greece, 4 points.
Greece, 4 points. Grèce, 4 points.
Italy, 6 points.
Italy, 6 points. Italy, 6 points.
Austria, 5 points.
Austria, 5 points. L'Autriche, 5 points.
Portugal, 1 point.
Portugal, 1 point. Portugal, 1 point.
Monaco, 2 points.
Monaco, 2 points. Monaco, 2 points.
And France, 3 points.
France, 3
well,
points.
Now.
La France, 3 points.
Britain are in a very, very strong position at present because, remember, France have to cast their vote
now.
Yet.
Good evening, Spain. May we have your vote,
and
please?
You could well be right.
Madrid calling. Here are the results from Spanish race. United Kingdom, 12 points.
Oh, yes.
United
yes.
Kingdom, 12 points. Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Switzerland, 4 points.
Switzerland, 4 points. La Suisse, 4 points.
Germany, 2 points.
Germany, 2 points. Allemagne, 2 points.
Israel, 1 point.
Israel, 1 point. Israel, 1 point.
Ireland, 5 points.
Ireland, 5 points. Irlande, 5 points.
The Netherlands, 3 points.
The Netherlands, 3 points. Les Pays-Bas, 3 points.
Finland, 6 points.
Finland, 6 points. Finland, 6 points.
Austria, 8 points.
Austria, 8 points. Autriche, 8 points.
Monaco, 7 points.
Monaco, 7 points. Monaco, 7 points.
And France, 10 points.
France, 10 points. La France, 10 points.
France, not out of it yet, by any means.
Thank you.
Thank you. Good night, Spain. And now Italy. Hello, Italy. May I have your votes, please?
More votes now. Plenty of votes over the next three countries.
Voici les résultats du jury italien. Royaume-Uni, 4 points.
Royaume-Uni, 4 points. United Kingdom, 4 points.
Israel, 10 points.
Israel, 10 points. Israel, 10 points.
That's the chocolate girl.
Belgique, 8 points.
Belgique, 8 points. Belgium, 8 points.
Irlande, 12 points.
so. 12 points
for Ireland there from Italy.
Pays-Bas, 2 points. Netherlands, 2 points.
Grèce, 5 points.
Greece, 5 points.
Espagne, 3 points.
Spain, 3 points.
Portugal, 1 point.
Portugal, 1 point.
Monaco, 7 points.
Monaco, 7 points. Monaco, 7 points.
France, 6 points.
Well, they needed more than that,
France,
really, there, France.
5 points.
6 points.
Six points.
Excuse me, please. It's all 6 points.
Ceci termine les points attribués par le jury italien.
Thank you very much, Italy. Bye-bye. Austria. Good evening, Austria. May I have your vote, please?
Harry van Hoff there with Sandra Raymer. Harry van Hoff, the composer of Holland. Sandra Raymer, the singer. 10 points for Britain.
Wyoming,
they're really getting the big score.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
Suisse, 8 points.
Switzerland, 8 points.
Israel, 6 points.
Israel, 6 points.
Belgique, 3 points.
Belgium, 3 points.
Irlande, 2 points.
Irlande, 2 points. Ireland, 2 points.
Pays-Bas, 4 points.
Pays-Bas, 4 points. Netherlands, 4 points.
Finlande, 7 points.
Finlande, 7 points. Finland, 7 points.
Italie, 1 point.
Italie, 1 point. Italie, 1 point.
Monaco, 5 points.
Monaco, 5 points.
France, 12 points.
Oh,
France,
that's 12 points now for France. It brings them
France,
right up on
12
Britain.
Points.
It's almost
thank
now down to a two-horse race. Monaco are there all right,
well,
but
well.
It's almost a two-horse race really now between Britain
two,
and
well,
France.
Let's go on. Let's try to get Portugal. Good evening, Portugal. May I have your votes, please?
These are the results of the Portuguese jury. United Kingdom, 12 points.
United Kingdom, 12 points. Royaume-Uni, 12 points.
Switzerland, 7 points.
Switzerland, 7 points. La Suisse, 7 points.
Israel, 2 points.
Israel, 2 points. Israel, 2 points.
Belgium, 8 points.
Belgium, 8 points. La Belgique, 8 points.
Netherlands, 6 points.
Netherlands, 6 points. Les Pays-Bas, 6 points.
Norway, 4 points.
Norway, 4 points. Norvège, 4 points.
Greece, 1 point.
Greece, 1 point. La Grèce, 1 point.
Italy, 10 points.
Italy, 10 points. L'Italie, 10 points.
Monaco, 3 points.
Monaco, 3 points. Monaco, 3 points.
And France, 5 points.
France, 5 points.
Well,
La France,
it will hardly be enough now for France, that's 5 points. They still have to vote,
thank
so they have only
Portugal.
Two more countries
bye-bye.
Now which can
bye-bye.
Give them maximum points.
Monaco. Hello, Monaco. Can you hear me? And may I have your vote,
that's Marie Christie, the singer for Monaco.
United Kingdom, 10 points. Royaume-Uni, 10 points.
La Suisse, 4 points.
La Suisse, 4 points. Switzerland, 4 points.
Israel, 1 point.
Israel, 1 point. Israel, 1 point.
Belgique, 8 points.
Belgique, 8 points. Belgium, 8 points.
Irlande, 6 points.
Irlande, 6 points. Ireland, 6 points.
Hollande, 2 points.
Les Pays-Bas, 2 points. Netherlands, 2 points.
Finlande, 7 points.
Finlande, 7 points. Finland, 7 points.
L'Espagne, 3 points.
L'Espagne, 3 points. Spain, 3 points.
L'Autriche,
5 points.
L'Autriche, 5 points. Austria, 5 points.
La France, 12 points.
La France,
well,
12 points.
10 points
France,
there now, France.
Points.
So, 12 points, rather. Well, they're still there.
Bonsoir, Monaco, et merci.
They're still there. It's quite exciting.
France, now. Good evening, France.
This,
can you
Anna Karina Stroh,
hello,
hey. Not too sure about the scoring.
Please.
Voici les
résultats
du
jury
français.
Royaume-Uni, 7 points. United Kingdom, 7 points. Suisse, 6 points. Switzerland, 6 points.
Allemagne, 2 points.
Allemagne, 2 points. Germany, 2 points.
Belgique, 5 points.
Belgique, 5 points. Belgium, 5 points.
Irlande, 3 points.
Irlande, 3 points. Ireland, 3 points.
Grèce, 8 points.
Grèce, 8 points. Greece, 8 points.
Espagne, 1 point.
Espagne, 1 point. Spain, 1 point.
Italie, 10 points.
Italie, 10 points. Italy, 10 points.
Portugal, 12 points.
Ah, Portugal, 12 points.
Portugal,
12 points.
Et ceci termine le vote attribué par le jury français. Bonsoir.
Bonsoir, merci, Pat. Yugoslavia, good evening. Can you hear me? And may I have your vote, please?
Good evening, Hart. Ljubljana calling.
It has been decided.
United Kingdom, 10 points.
It has
United
most definitely
Kingdom,
been decided.
10 points. Royaume-Uni,
that's it, it's all over now. Britain have won.
Switzerland, 7 points.
Switzerland,
celebrations
7
already.
Points. La Suisse, 7 points.
Germany, 3 points.
Germany, 3 points. Allemagne, 3 points.
Israel, 8 points.
Israel, 8 points. Israel, 8 points.
Ireland, 1 point.
Ireland, 1 point. Irlande, 1 point.
Netherlands, 5 points.
Netherlands, 5 points. Les Pays-Bas, 5 points.
Italy, 6 points.
Italy, 6 points. Italy, 6 points.
Austria, 2 points.
Austria, 2 points. Autriche, 2 points.
Monaco, 4 points.
Monaco, 4 points.
Putting Monaco into third place.
France, 12 points.
Oh,
France,
yes.
12 points.
12 points for France. They were fighting right to the end.
And that completes the points of the Yugoslav jury. Thank you and
thank
good
you,
night.
Thank you, Yugoslavia, so, and goodbye.
No tie at all. A clear-cut victory for Britain. Brotherhood of man.
And so, ladies and gentlemen,
and save your kisses
means
for me.
That the United Kingdom won.
Quoted by William Hill of London as the 3-1 favourites, and they have done just that. They have fulfilled the role
English, so
in which they were cast.
With a song written by Tony Hiller, Ree Sheridan and Martin Lee, and sung by the Brotherhood of Men. And Getty, our singer of last year's winning group Teach-In, is now going to hand over the Grand Prix of the Eurovision Song Contest of this year. Cela veut dire, mesdames et messieurs, qu'a...
Well, Red acquitted themselves very well. Ireland finished somewhere around the middle, but it was a very clear-cut victory for Britain. France were in second place and Monaco were in third place.
Remettra maintenant le Grand Prix Eurovision de la chanson. Dat wil dus zeggen, dames en heren, dat Engeland heeft gewonnen met hun liedje, gecomponeerd door
Getty, by the way, the young lady who was the lead singer in Teach-In's group, who sang Ding Dang A Dong to victory last year, the reason why the contest is in The Hague, has now commenced a solo career. She called a press conference during the week to announce that she has gone solo, that Teach-In has now broken up. And there they are, Brotherhood of Man. The victors, according the applause they deserve.
The two lads in the group there, Lee Sheridan and Martin Lee, are two of the authors. There's Tony Hiller on the stage with them as well. Alan Ainsworth standing down there. Tony Hiller with Getty. And there's the medallion they receive as composers. Well, there we are. Halfway it was between France and Britain, and it finished up. Britain number one, and here it is, the winning Eurovision song.
Though it hurts to go away, it's impossible to stay. But there's one thing I must say before I go. I love you.
I love you.
You know, I'll be thinking of you in most everything. Thing I do now, the time is moving on, and I really should be gone. But you keep me hanging on for one more smile. I love you,
I love you
all the while. With your cute little way, will you promise that you'll say your
kisses for me? Save all your kisses for me.
No, you've got to say that I've got to work each day, and that's why I go away. But I count the seconds till I'm home with you. I love you.
I love you.
It's true. You're so cute, honey G. Won't you save them up for me?
Composer who just stepped in was conducting the audience in their hand clapping applause and sing along right through that encore. Brocken is certainly speaking, as obviously she's having difficulties with the microphone. She's reiterating that the Grand Prix of the Eurovision Song Contest has been won by Brotherhood of Man for England. And now the helping male hand.
De grote prijs van het Eurovisie Songfestival naar dit gelukkige Engeland. En wij feliciteren de winnaar en wij danken 500 miljoen televisiekijkers en radioluisteraars om met ons mee te willen zijn vanavond. En hier besluit de NOS deze 21ste finale van het Eurovisie Songfestival vanuit Den Haag, dames en heren. Goedenavond. Le Grand Prix Eurovision, mesdames et messieurs, est donc gagné par l'Angleterre. Nos félicitations pour les gagnantes et nous remercions les 500 millions de spectateurs et d'auditeurs. Et c'est ainsi que la NOS termine cette 21e finale du Grand Prix Eurovision de la chanson. Depuis La Haye, mesdames et messieurs,
Au revoir. Au revoir et bonsoir. Ladies and gentlemen, and the Grand Prix of the Eurovision Song Contest went to the United Kingdom. We congratulate the winner and we thank 500 million of listeners and viewers for being with us during this 21st International Song Contest 1976. From The Hague in Holland, ladies and gentlemen, good night. Bye-bye.
With our commiserations and yes, our congratulations to Red Hurley and Brendan Graham, and indeed our sincere congratulations to Brotherhood of Man, we say good night to you from The Hague. Good night.